Good morning, children.
Good morning.
Fine. Now, before I start the lesson, in the previous class, I said that I'll be asking you one question. In the textbook, we have found in the right-hand side, isn't it? While reading the lesson. Okay, what is that question? Why do frogs breathe with two organs? Why do frogs breathe with two organs? Isn't it? Did you think? Fine. Now I am going to give the answer for this. Frogs live in water as well as on land. And also the frog is an amphibian. What is it? The frog is an amphibian. What is the definition of amphibian? Amphibians are the animals which live in water as well as on land. That is why frog has two organs. How many organs? Two organs. When the frog lives in water, it breathes through its skin. When the frog lives on land, it breathes through its lungs. Got it? Now, let us have a recap of previous classes. What do we learn in the previous classes? What is the lesson name? Things around us. Isn't it? And what are the things are classified? Things are classified into living things and non-living things. Now let us learn about the definition of living things. What is the definition of living things? Living things are the things which have life. What is the definition of non-living things? Non-living things are things which do not have life. What are the examples of living things? Human beings, plants and animals. And what are the examples of non-living things? Bench, table, door, etc. Isn't it? Now, living things differ from non-living things in many ways. Next, what we have learned? We have learned the characteristics of living things. What are the characteristics of living things? How many characteristics of living things are there? 8. What are there? They are food, water, grow, breathe, move, stimulus and respond, reproduce, and the last one is die. Let us have a quick look what we have learned in the previous classes. We have learned 5 characteristics of living things. The first one is the food, water and grow. Let us discuss about this. All human beings and animals depend on the plants for food. Human beings and animals drink water. And what about the plants? Plants prepare their own food. Roots absorb the water from the soil and it transports to all parts of a plant. That is about food and water. Then coming to the grow. Human beings grow from infant baby to adult human. From chick to hen. From puppy to dog, etc. Now let us talk about living things, breathe and move. What are the organs present in different living organisms? Now, human beings breathe through their lungs. Animals like cow, goat, puppy, dog, etc. They also breathe through their lungs. Coming to the aquatic animals like fish, oyster, prawns, etc. They breathe through their gills. They breathe through their gills. Now let us talk about the amphibians like frog breathe with two organs. Breathe with two organs. When it is in water, it breathes through skin. When it is on land, it breathes through lungs. Fine. Now coming to the plants. Plants breathe through tiny small pores present on the surface of the leaf called stomata. The plants breathe through its stomata. What are the organs present in the insects, children? Insects like butterfly, cockroach, etc. They breathe through spiracles. They breathe through spiracles. Now, let us learn how living things move. The organs which help the living things to move are called locomotory organs. Humans move in different ways. They crawl, they walk, and they run. Snake slithers.
Plants move their body parts. Fish swims with their fins. Birds fly with wings. Flight feathers help them to fly.
In today's class, we are going to learn the other two characteristics of living things. What are those, children? Stimulus and respond and reproduce. How living things stimulus and respond and how living things reproduce. Let us learn about stimulus and respond and reproduce. Stimulus means nothing but feelings. What is that? Feelings. Living things feel and respond. Living things feel and respond.
Now students, let us learn about the other characteristics of living things. That is, living things feel and respond. We laugh when we are happy. We cry when it pains. Anger, pain, pleasure, etc. are the feelings. Now students, let us learn about what is stimulus and what is response. What is stimulus and what is response? Now let us learn about first stimulus. Stimulus is anything that causes a response. What is that, students? Stimulus is anything that causes a response. Now what is response? Reaction to an event is called response. Reaction to an event is called response. Let us see a few examples of stimulus and response in human beings. When we touch hot things, immediately you will withdraw your hand due to heat. That means touching hot pan is stimulus and withdrawing hand due to heat is response. Now one more example. When bad smell comes, we close our nose. In this, what is the stimulus and what is the response? In this example, bad smell is stimulus, closing the nose is response. What is that, children? Bad smell is stimulus, closing the nose is response. Good. Now, let us learn how do plants respond to stimuli. Sunflowers follow the sunlight throughout the day from east to west. Later at night, in its absence, the sunflowers face east again, waiting for the sun's return. Now coming to the touch me not plant. Touch me not plant is sensitive plant. When we touch the leaves of the plant, immediately it folds the leaves. Again, when we shake it, opens the leaves. Here, touching is stimulus and closing the leaves is response. To observe the response to stimuli in insects, let us do a small activity. Take a pinch of sugar and keep it at some place in a room. Observe after 15 to 30 minutes. You can see ants and houseflies near the sugar. What made these ants come towards the sugar? In this case, the smell of sugar attracts the ants. Here, the sugar is the stimulus and the movements of ants towards it is the response. Students, now let us learn about the stimulus and response in animals. First picture you observe, children, what the dog is doing? Yes, it's wagging the tail. What is it doing? It is wagging the tail. The dog wags the tail when it is feeling happy. In this picture, happy is stimulus. Wagging tail is response. Wagging tail is response. Now, observe the second picture. What did you find in the second picture? You can see dog, meat and water drops. Isn't it? What the dog is doing there? In this picture, you can see that the dog is drooling over the meat. Here, stimulus is meat. Drooling is the response. Drooling is response. Drooling means watering in the mouth. Watering in the mouth. Students, let us learn about the other characteristic of living things. That is, reproduce. Living things reproduce. Now, let us learn about the definition of reproduction. Process by which living things produce the young ones of their own kind is called reproduction. I repeat, process by which living things produce the young ones of their own kind is called reproduction. Humans give birth to their young ones. Children, now let us learn how do animals reproduce. Animals reproduce in two ways. By laying eggs, by giving birth to young ones. What are those? By laying eggs, by giving birth to young ones. Can you tell children that animals lay eggs? Hen, pigeon, etc. Good. Many other animals like birds, fish, insects, frogs, tortoises, crocodiles, etc. reproduce by laying eggs. Reproduce by laying eggs. Can you tell children that animals give birth to young ones? Dog, cow, goat, etc. Good. Children, here is an example of a hen reproducing by laying eggs. Mother or father bird often warms and protects the eggs till they hatch. Once the egg matured, the young ones hatch out. The young ones of a hen is called a chick. Children, now let us see a few examples of animals that reproduce by giving birth to young ones. Giving birth to young ones. See the first picture. The young one of a dog is called puppy. What do you call the young one of a dog? Puppy. The young one of a cat is called kitten. What do you call the cat young one? Kitten. Good. The young one of a horse is called pony. What do you call the young one of a horse? Pony. Good. Coming to reproduction in insects, like cockroach, reproduce by laying eggs. The egg develops into small cockroach called nymph. N-Y-M-P-H. What is the spelling of nymph? N-Y-M-P-H. Which grows finally into a adult cockroach. The nymph which grows finally into a adult cockroach. Do you know, students, that plants also reproduce like animals? The mode of reproduction differs from plant to plant. The mode of reproduction differs from plant to plant. Plants reproduce through seeds. Examples: papaya, apple, tomato, etc. Through buds, potato, ginger, onion, etc. Through stem, rose, hibiscus, etc. Reproduction in many plants is through seeds. Students, listen carefully. Reproduction in many plants is through seeds. Plants produce seeds which germinate and grow into a new plants. Plants produce seeds which germinate and grow into a new plants. Now, let us see an example how reproduction take place through potato buds. Take potatoes with buds called as eyes. Now, cut the potato into 4 or 5 pieces with each piece having one bud or eye. Bury these pieces in the soil and water them regularly. After a few days, the bud present on the potato develop into stems and leaves. In the same wise, we can grow ginger, turmeric, etc. Let us perform an activity to learn next method of reproduction. Cut a branch from a rose plant or a mehendi plant. Fix it in the soil. Water it regularly. Observe it. After a few days, what do you find? We find that the cutting has got small new shoots. This activity proves that plants can reproduce through cuttings also. Let's have a quick check. The young ones of different animals have different names. Find the names of the young ones of the following animals: dog, puppy, cat, kitten, cow, calf, horse, foal or pony. Let us go through the word wallet. I pronounce the words, listen carefully. Stimulus, response, reproduction, laying, movements, sunlight, young ones, process. Now I spell the words. STIMULUS, stimulus. RESPONS, response. REPRODUCTION, reproduction. LAYING, laying. MOVEMENTS, movements. SUNLIGHT, sunlight. YOUNGONES, young ones. PROCESS, process. As we have completed discussing the lesson, let us now read the lesson once. Concentrate and listen carefully. Try to follow and read with me. Are you ready, children? Yes, let's start reading the lesson. Living things feel and respond. Let's do it. Take a pinch of sugar and keep it at some place in a room. Observe. After 15 to 30 minutes, you can see ants and houseflies near the sugar. What made these ants come towards the sugar? In this case, the smell of sugar attracts the ants. Here, the sugar is the stimulus and the movements of ants towards it is the response. If you put a potted plant near a window, you can observe that the plant bends towards the sunlight. So, anything that causes a response in a living thing is called stimulus. The plant movements in a Tashmi knot plant and a sunflower plant that we discussed earlier are also the responses towards a particular stimulus. A plant bends towards sunlight. Leaves of the Tashmi knot plant curls up when we touch. Living things reproduce. Process by which living things produce the young ones of their own kind is called reproduction. All living things reproduce. Animals reproduce either by laying eggs or by giving birth to young ones. Animals like birds, frog, fish, most of the snakes, etc., lay eggs to produce young ones. Mice, dog, cat, man, etc., give birth to young ones. Quick check. The young ones of different animals have different names. Find the names of the young ones of the following animals: dog, puppy, cat, kitten, cow, calf, horse, pony. Many plants reproduce with the help of seeds. Some plants also reproduce through stems, leaves, and roots.
Let us have a quick check what you have learned in this class. What are the characteristics you have learned in this class? Stimulus and respond and reproduce. You have learned that living things stimulus and respond and reproduce. Can you give an example of stimulus and respond? What does a puppy do? Yes. When it is happy, what does it do? It wags its tail. Did you observe it? Good. Now, that is happy means stimulus and wagging the tail is respond. Good children. And also you have seen in plants and also in flowers. Isn't it? Which plant did you see in the plants? You have seen touch me not plant. When you touch it, what does that happens? It curls the leaves. Coming to the sunflower, what did you observe in the sunflower? It turns to the sun. It turns to the sun. Good. What did we learn in this class? One more characteristics of living things. Living things reproduce. What do you mean by reproduction? What is the definition of reproduction? Process by which living things produce the young ones of their own kind is called reproduction. Come again. Process by which living things produce the young ones of their own kind is called reproduction. Humans give birth to their small babies. Coming to the animals. Animals reproduce in two ways. How many ways? In two ways. The first one is laying eggs. The second one is giving birth to their young ones. Laying eggs. What are the examples of laying eggs? Hen, pigeon, etc. Giving birth to young ones. Cow, goat, buffalo, etc. In the next class, we will talk about the lifespan of living things. And also non-living things, natural things, and man-made things.